What's up, everyone? Coach Vanessa, Coach Britt here with you with today's workout. Now, before we get started, let's go over our warm-up. We're going to have two rounds starting off with our warm-up. We're going to have 30 seconds of high knees, 30 seconds of butt kickers, 30 seconds of groiners, and then 30 seconds of a plank hold. So those high knees, you're just driving your knees up as high as you can get them. 30 seconds. Then we're going to go into 30 seconds of our butt kickers, so just kicking those heels up. And then we're going to take it down to the ground into our groiner. So we're going to start at the top of a push-up position. So take it down to the ground. Wrists are stacked right underneath our shoulders. We're bracing our core. From here, we're just going to send one leg up, and we're going to try to get it as high as we can, as close as the opposite hand. So from here, you want to maintain that nice 90-degree angle of your knee. Sink that lower hip, so it's a good hip opener, good hip stretch. And then you're just going to alternate legs. So opposite leg comes up, sink that hip. So nice, good stretch for 30 seconds. And from here, we're going to take it into that plank hold. So you're actually going to stay down on the mat. So from here, I'll take it to the top of that high plank. Wrists are underneath the shoulders. Glutes are squeezed. Belly is nice and tight. And you're just going to hold for 30 seconds. So that'll be your warm up. You'll repeat it one additional round before we get into the workout. For the workout, it's a good one. We're going to set a clock for 4 minutes, and we're going to repeat it three additional times for a total of 4 sets. We're going to start off with 2 minutes of up downs. So on that movement, we're going to squat down. Hands are going to come down to the mat. You're going to kick your feet out into a high plank, squeezing those glutes as you kick out. And then you're just going to kick your feet back up to your hands and stand. So I'll do that for 2 minutes. A modification to that are going to be those step backs. So you'll squat down, hands go down to the mat, step each foot back, step it up, and stand. Now, if you find that a little too difficult, if you just need to go where you're touching your toes, so go down into a toe tap, then just come on up, hands cut, yep, and then stand. There you go. So that's a modification to that if the up downs are a little too difficult to perform. So you'll do that for 2 minutes, and then we're going to go into 15 dumbbell ground to overheads. So our dumbbells are going to start right between our feet, so we'll take a wider stance. We're going to have two variations on this one. We can go single dumbbell. So you're going to go down, you're going to grab that dumbbell from here, you're just going to punch it overhead. Biggest thing here is to keep that dumbbell nice and close as you're punching it overhead. And then on that lockout above your head, you want to be sure that you're keeping that bicep nice and close to your ear. So you'll just take it for 15 reps. The other option or variation is going to go double dumbbell ground to overhead. So this time you'll grab both dumbbells. Same thing. You're just going to jump and then punch them both overhead. So just maintain that nice tummy, squeeze those glutes up at the top as you're punching those dumbbells overhead, and keep those biceps nice and close to those ears. And then you're gonna finish it off with 10 push-ups. So we're going back down to the mat, starting off at that high plank. Wrists are stacked right underneath the shoulders, belly squeezed nice and tight, glutes are squeezed nice and tight. And then from here, we're just going to bend at the elbows while maintaining a nice rigid body. So chest and thighs hit the ground, and then you're going to push on up for 10 reps. Your other option is to do them from your knees. So come down on your knees, same thing, bend at the elbows, chest hits the ground, and then push up. You'll do that for 10 reps. So on that 4 minute running clock, whatever time is left, you'll rest. And then you're gonna start that all over again. Those 2 minute of up downs, 15 dumbbell ground overheads, and then finishing off with those push-ups. So really work to try and get all of those movements done in about 3.5 minutes so that you at least have 15 to 30 seconds of rest before you take it on to the next set. So have fun, it's a good one. Get nice and sweaty, get after it.